is to be critical of the journalism that has been deployed in relation to Gaza, as well to keep in mind that there are many, many journalists in this country, across the water and elsewhere, who are as deeply concerned and troubled about the BBC and other coverage of this conflict as is anybody here. There are demonstrations in Derry over the past couple of weeks. We have had a number of gatherings outside BBC Radio 5, and delighted to say that in every one of them, we have had the banner of the Derry and North West branch of the National Union of Journalists, representing the consensus view of journalists in our area. I can also tell you that there are journalists in the BBC who may find it difficult to speak out, but we are, and I know we are talking about personally and through union activity, who are as concerned as anybody else, perhaps even more so in a way, because it is their broadcasting organisation which is perpetrating the distortions and the lies which are being spread about the Gaza conflict. When we have interviews, whether it's on the BBC or anywhere else, which presses interviewees to say what they think about the Hamas rockets and whether or not the Israeli Defence Forces had a right to launch the onslaught against Gaza in retaliation, as they phrase it, for the Hamas rockets. That is a lie. That implicitly is a lie, because it takes no context for what is happening. To select the beginning of Hamas firing rockets in the recent past, to select that as the beginning of the conflict, is to endorse the Israeli narrative of what is happening, and it is to dismiss and make rubbish of the Palestinian narrative. This is not objectivity. This is not balance, irrespective of the questions that are put to various interviewees. Balance, when we talk about journalism and broadcasting journalism, is often understood as to be balance between one interview and another. Balance between the amount of time given to a spokesperson for one side and a spokesperson for the other. That is not the point. Without context being given, without putting the conflict in its historical context, lies are being told. The people packed into Gaza is never explained in news reports. The people packed into Gaza and today bearing the brunt of a murderous onslaught, they in the overwhelming majority do not come from that little patch of earth in the Middle East. Almost all of them are refugees. They are people who were forced to flee in 1948 from the disaster which overtook the Palestinian people to make way for the establishment of the Israeli state. That's what we're talking about. That's what we're talking about. Without understanding that, without that context being put, it is impossible for a viewer or a listener to understand fully what is happening there. You're forced to wonder, standing outside the BBC, whatever happened to the idea of a mission to explain, which is in the BBC's founding charter. There is no mission to explain here. It played out only a mission to present one side, the side with the Western powers back, so in relation to the Gaza conflict. We must speak out against that, so we must be clear that the electors are powering back, because this is to tell lies about the Palestinian people. No issue in our time has so ignited the anger and the passion of people all around the world than the Palestinian issue. In every generation, there is an issue which emerges as the defining issue for that generation. In the 1930s, it was the Spanish Civil War. It was followed by the apartheid issue, the Vietnam War issue. Today, the defining issue for all the world is Gaza, is Palestine. I don't expect the BBC to represent my point of view. I wish they would, but that would be unrealistic. I do expect them to present the news from Gaza in a way which enables and facilitates an understanding of what is actually happening there. That is the essence of Qatar journalism. When I say that Palestine is a defining issue for this generation, I am referring to the fact that the example given to the world by the Palestinian people is an inspiration to every misused, abused, oppressed, and repressed people right across the planet. Palestine is standing up for everybody. And convicted